Greetings, everyone, nerds and geeks and aliens and robots and what have you not. If you are running Windows and you want a amazing cleaning tool or, well, PC management tool to help you sanitize, you know, your Windows once in a while, keep it up to snuff, keep it clean, you know, think of it as a health check, you know, give it a health check once in a while to make sure that all the vitamins are there, you know, it's not going to do dirty things that you don't want it to do. Get PC Manager. It is in public beta, but get it. It's an amazing tool. And I will just go over with it here. You can give some feedback. You can exit it, of course. It will run every time you boot up your computer down here, and you can just exit it if you don't want to do that. Going to settings here. So start PC Manager. When I sign into Windows, you can basically just take that off. We can also check for updates. There's no updates. Here, we can boost the memory. You can just click boost. Pops younger. If you have any rogue things running in memory, we can do that. Health check, looking for issues. Reset default browser to Edge. This is like, I hate Microsoft for doing this. Start up apps to disable. So, you know, if you don't want any of these to start up, so it could be VMware tools, it could be Radmin. If you have any other things, you can just click them there and then click proceed. Storage management. Storage cells automatically clean up temporary files. So it will open up your settings here. And keep Windows running smoothly by automatically cleaning up temporary files and app files. And you can go into more detail about it here. I don't know about this automatically user content cleanup. I would be a little bit hesitant by using that, but keep this on. It basically just removing your temp folder once in a while and stuff like those things in it. Managing apps. Again, it's just opening up your control center here, and apps. And you can go in here and you can uninstall apps you don't want and don't need. I would, however, recommend using uninstaller that also check your registry keys and leftovers, because there will be registry entrances that by uninstalling it normally, it will not be erased. That could bog down your system or make your system finicky. And if there's leftover, it will save disk space. I'm using, I can't remember, Vovo uninstall or what it's called for years now. And it checks the registry database and it checks my hard drive for leftovers. And it just helps me keep a functioning clean version of Windows running. So I don't have weird leftovers laying around causing issues. And I recommend using that instead, or something equivalent to that instead. Manage large files. If you have a tendency to download a lot of, I don't know, large files that you don't need, you can search for that and delete it here. I would be really careful with this because it could remove, you know, game folders and stuff like that. So I would be a little bit iffy with that one. But this one up here is probably the one that you're going to use the most. The disk cleanup. You basically just take what you want to clean up and you click proceed. Well, it goes even further. We have storage management. We already looked at that. Process management. So right here, end unused processes to make your system run faster. So if you open this one here and you see stuff that, hey, I don't need that. Why is that running there? I can just end Redmin VPN or Redmin VPN. I could end the VMware tools core services. Know what you are doing, because most people that get into problems with Windows is because they don't know what they're doing. So don't, if you see something here and you're like, should I end it? Don't. If you're questioning yourself, don't. Take the name, go on to the good old Google, and then you type in the name of the software or the name of the service. You see now Google Chrome is running over here. Startup apps. You can go in here and you can tweak what startup apps that you want or not want. There are different ways of doing it under Windows. You go into computer management. You can do it via the task manager. Under, let's see, where do we have it? Startup apps, you can do it in here also. But you have a nice little tool of doing it here. You go into security. It can scan for threats. It can check you for updates and stuff like that. It's basically just a one-stop place for everything computer, not everything, but the most common computer management stuff that an end user would be doing that are not going, knee deep into becoming a system administrator, doing system administrative tasks. This is more like my mom would be using it, an accountant would be using it. You know, you install this for your what is it called? Customer service department. You install it for your accountant department. You install it for your R&D department. And you like every Friday before you go home, you do these processes. You do a health check. You do a storage management, disk cleanup. And you may do a security check. Do that every Friday. Instead of telling them, okay, you have to go into settings and then you have to go into this submenu to do this thing, go into another submenu to do another thing. It gets really, really confusing for a lot of people. Here, they run one program. And it takes care of that. That's my kind of viewpoint of this app, is that it's not something I would personally be using, because I go into the good old control center and do it myself once in a while. Or have other programs that do it a little bit more efficiently than either this one does or this one does here. And how do you get it? Well, just search it. PC Manager, Microsoft Windows, or PC Manager, Microsoft Windows app. I'll put the link to this down below. And it is in, I think it's Mandarin. Some of the text is in, I think that's what they call it. Or, well, it's not anymore. It used to be anyway. Maybe it's auto-translated, I don't know. PCManager.en.microsoft.com. Maybe that's why I, you know, effed it up. So I hope this was helpful. Any questions, down below. See you later. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.